A very good morning to all of you. Hope you students are keeping well and fine. So students, let's start the supplementary reader, the first lesson, The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse, which is written by William Saroyan. So we will start this supplementary reader with very enthusiastically. So let's start, and I am going to give the brief introduction of this lesson first, then the brief summary, then I will explain you the paragraph wise. Okay, so let's start. The lesson of the snapshot, The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse, is written by William Saroyan. The story is about two Armenian boys, Aram and Morad, who belongs to the Gargolian family. Their tribe is known for their honesty. They are poor and can hardly earn money for food. They both long to ride a horse. Morad had stolen her horse from a farmer a month ago. One early morning, he brought it to the window of Aram and asked him to come along for a ride. They rode the horse for many days. When Aram gets to know the horse is stolen, he gets shocked but discounts the stealing in his mind. One day, the owner of the horse, John Bryo, comes to his house to complain about his missing horse to Uncle Kosaro. So one day, on their way back to hide the horse on the deserted vineyard, they meet the owner and feel guilty at the end. Next morning, they return the horse back to the owner's barn. So first, I have given you the introduction. Just see the brief summary of this lesson so that you can understand it very well. So what happened, the first part of the story, that Aram and Morad were two poor boys who belonged to the Armenian Gargolian family, who were known for their honesty since the 11th century. One early morning, when Aram was asleep and was enjoying pleasant dreams, his cousin Morad showed up to his window with a beautiful white horse. Aram could not believe it and was thinking it was a dream. But since there was a little light outside, he knew this for sure, that the horse was real, as they were poverty stricken. He could not believe that the horse was their own. He was trying to figure out if the horse had been stolen by his cousin Morad, who had come to invite him for a ride along. He asked him to make it quick before everyone in the world wakes up. Aram wore his clothes and jumped out of the window and sat behind Morad on the horse. So what happened next time, though, they rode on the old countryside of the area where they lived, Walnut Avenue. After some time, Morad asked him to get off as he wanted to ride the horse again, horse alone. Aram asked him if he could so ride the horse along just him, like to which Morad said that they will see it was for his own safety. He got to know that Morad had stolen the horse for a month ago and was riding every morning. When Aram got his chance for a ride, the horse took him to the vineyard and threw him off and ran away. After searching for 30 minutes, Morad finally managed to find the horse, and they hid him in a deserted vineyard and that had some oats and aloe. Morad had a way with everyone, especially horses. He knew how to handle every type of animal and also humans. Every morning, for 2 weeks, they could take the horse for a ride, then hit it again. One day, what happened, you know, that John Bryo came to Aram's house to talk to his uncle Kosarov, who was a very irritated and very loud man, who shouted at almost everything. Briar told him about his missing horse, whom he had bought at $60. For 1 month, he couldn't find it, and he walked for 10 miles to come to their house. Kosarov roared at him and told him, "It's no harm, pay no attention to it." Briar became irritated. Irritated and by his attitude, and he went away. Aram went to Morat and told him about the missing horse of Briar and asked him not to return the horse until he learns to ride it. Morat told him that it would take 1 year for him to learn to ride the horse. He further angrily added that they would not could not be thieves, as their tribe is known for honesty, and said that they would return the horse after 6 months. One day, on their back to their hide the horse to the hidden spot, they met John Briar, who was going to the town. He talked to him to them and carefully examined the horse. He admitted that the horse looked exactly like the one he had, but since he knew his parents and the honesty of their family, he did not believe that they had his missing horse. He assumed it was a twin horse. Morat managed to let Briar assume that it was not his horse, so they went away. The next morning, both of them took the horse back to Briar Vineyard and put it in the barn. The dogs followed them all along quietly, and they felt the place. The same afternoon, John Briar came back to his house to tell his mother about his horse who had come back. He was happy and was astonished to see the horse's better temper, and it was stronger than ever. Uncle Kosarov again wrote, "Quiet, man, quiet. Your horse has been returned. Pay no attention to it." So this was the short brief summary I have given to you about this lesson, Summer of the Beautiful White Horse. Now I will give you the paragraph wise explanation. So listen carefully, you will be able to understand it properly. Okay, so let's start. So first paragraph, it is given the summary in this way. So what happened the first paragraph? One day, 9-year-old Aram was asleep, and he was in the world of extremely beautiful imagination. His life was pleasant and kind of in a very mysterious dream. His cousin Morat showed up on the window of his room at 4 o'clock in the morning. He called Aram, who jumped out of his bed and still couldn't believe what he saw out of the window. It was dawn, and there was light enough outside to make him see outside, what made him believe he wasn't dreaming. So next paragraph, it says that Morat was sitting on a white horse. Aram rubbed his eyes and stuck on out his head out of the window. Morat assured him it was not a dream. He asked if he wanted a ride, he must make it quick. Morat was the type of a person who enjoyed being alive, but he couldn't believe that he was seeing a horse in front of him. Aram's earliest memory was of horses, and he always wanted to ride one. This was the wonderful part, that he was actually going to ride a horse for real. So next paragraph, it says, explained in this way, that Aram's family was poor and had no money, so it was difficult for him to believe in what he saw outside his house. He belonged to the Gargolian family that was strictly and fondly in poverty. They didn't even know how they managed to get food for themselves every day. although his tribe was poor. They were known for their honesty for 11 centuries. They were honest, proud, and always believed in the right and wrong. No one from their family could ever steal anything or could take advantage of anyone in the world. So in the next paragraph, it happened in this way that Aram was so excited that he was seeing a horse that was so pleasant and beautiful. He could smell it and hear it breathing and still couldn't believe that Murad or anyone in the family could afford a horse. He was thinking if Murad had stolen the horse, but he did not believe it as he thought no one in his family could be a thief. So he stared at his cousin and then at the horse. There was a religious motionlessness and wittiness in both Murad and the horse, as one charmed him and the other scared him. He asked Murad if he had stolen the horse. Murad replied that if he wants a ride, he must jump out of the window. Aram was convinced that the horse was stolen by Murad. He came to visit him to ask him to ride it with him. Aram tried to convince himself that it was not the same as stealing money, as they both were so crazy about riding a horse. He thought that it would not be called stealing until they decide to sell it, which they would never do. Aram said he will wear some clothes and come outside. He jumped to his yard from his room's window and sat on the horse behind his cousin. Aram lived at the edge of the town on the Walnut Avenue. There were orchards, vineyards, irrigation ditches and country roads behind his house. They were on Olive Avenue. Within 3 minutes, the horse started to proceed. The air felt new and lovely to breathe. Aram felt wonderful sitting on the horse which was running. Murad started singing loudly, who was considered one of the craziest members of the family. There is one crazy person in every family, and Murad was the one natural descendant of crazy race in their tribe. Before Murad was Uncle Khosrow, was one huge man with black hair and the largest mustache in the valley. He had an energetic temper and was impatient, which was irritating. He used to make anyone stop talking by roaring and say, "It's no harm, pay no attention to it." Uncle Khosrow was always this rigid, no matter what happened to be talking about in front of him. Once his own son, Arav, came running to him when he was getting his mustache trimmed at the barber's shop. He told him the house was on fire, to which he roared and said the same dialogue. Barber was as amused and tried to talk to him about it, but as usual, Khosrow roared again, did not pay attention to it. Murad was considered to be the natural descendant of this man, but he was not his son. His father was Zorab, who was a practical person. A child could look like his father, but doesn't mean he gets his nature and attitude just the same. There are different kinds of people in their tribes, Moody, and without any settled work or home, they were still riding the horse, and Murad was still singing loudly. They were still in the countryside where, according to their neighbors, they belonged to. Murad asked him to get down as he wanted to ride alone. Aram asked if he could ride the horse alone. He said, "It is up to the horse if he wants to ride you along, and asked him to get Murad down again. Aram tried to convince him that the horse would let him ride, to which Murad said that we shall see, and told Aram that he had a way with horse. Aram told him that he had hit too. Mora told him to get down and said it is for his own safety. Let us hope. So Aram got down while telling him that he will ride the horse and shouted run to him. The horse stood on its hind legs, breathed out and ran into speed. Morad raised the horse across a field of dry grass and irrigation ditches. When they arrived 5 minutes later, they were wet. Then the sun was almost up and Aram told him it was his turn to ride. Morad got off and Aram sat on the horse. He was fearful and the horse did not move. Morad tried to guide him by saying that he should try to kick into his muscles and told him that he should hurry because they need to take him back before everyone woke up. Aram kicked into the muscles of the horse, to which the horse again raised and breathed out. The horse began to run and Aram did not know what to do next. Horse started going towards the road that lead to the vineyard of Dikran Halabian. Heat began to move over vines and Aram fell down. The horse continued to run and Morad came running down the road towards him. Morad told him that he is not worried about him, but they need to find the horse. They both went different ways to find him. He instructed Aram to be kind if he saw him anywhere. So next, what happened? Aram looked for the horse down the road and Morad went towards the irrigation ditch. He came back after 30 minutes with the horse. He told him to jump over. The whole world was awake by then. Aram was asked what would they do now, to which Mora told him about two options: take him back to or hide him until tomorrow. Morad was not worried. Aram knew the Morad would hide him somewhere and not take him back for a while. Aram asked him where Morad would hide him. Mora told him about a place where he knew which would be perfect as a hidden spot. Aram eagerly asked him when he stole the horse. It appeared to him that Morad had been taking the horse for morning rides for quite some time. And he showed up this morning to ask Aram to ride along because he knew he was longing to ride a one. So what happened next? That Morad shuts him down by asking a counter question about who talks about stealing a horse. Aram tried to change the question by asking him since how long was he riding the horse every morning. Morad told him that the morning was the first time and Aram was not convinced and asked him if he was telling the truth. Mora said if anyone asked Aram, he should say that it was true. He further added that he did not want them to be liars, but they had to say only this. Aram agreed and Morad walked the horse quietly towards the barn of the deserted vineyards. It belonged to a farmer named Fetch Vegian. Barn had some oats and alafa. They started walking home. Morad told Aram that it was not easy to get the horse to behave nicely as it wanted to run wild at first. He told him again that he had a way with the horse and he could get them to do whatever he wants to do. Horses understood him. Aram was amusingly asked him how he controlled the horse, to which Mora said he was an understanding with the horse. Aram asked him, what sort of understanding did he have with him, to which Mora told him, a simple and a very honest one. Aram confessed that he would also like to know how to have an understanding with the horse. Mora assured Aram by saying that he is still a small boy and he will learn when he will be 13. Aram went home and ate breakfast. That day, his uncle Kosarov visited his house for coffee and cigarettes. He sat in the parlor and was remembering the old country when a person came to visit him. He was who? John Bryo, a farmer who learned to speak Armenian because of the loneliness. His mother brought Bryo some coffee and tobacco. He sipped and smoked and told them about his missing white horse who was stolen last month and he is not able to find it out. Kosarov wrote again that is no harm and shouted that why he was crying over a lost horse when they had lost their homeland. John replied to Kosarov that he would not bother as he lives in a city, but his country was of no good without his horse. Kosarov shouted that he must not pay any attention to it. John told him that he walked down 10 miles to come here. Kosarov shouted that he has legs, to which John said his left leg hurt. Kosarov again tried to shut him down by saying that he should not pay any attention to it. John shared that the horse cost him $60. Kosarov said that he would spit on the money, after which John would got up and went away, and slamming the door. Aram's mother told him that John had a gentle heart as he was homesick and he was such a large man. Aram went to Morad and he was sitting under a peach tree talking to a robin bird, and he was repairing the wing that was hurt. Aram told him about John Bryo and how he visited their house and he wanted his house. Aram asked him not to return the horse until he learns to ride it. After that, Morad told Aram that it will take him a long year to learn to ride a horse. Aram said that they could keep him for a year then. Morad stood up on his feet and shouted at him about encouraging him to be a thief in spite of being a member of the Gargolian family. He declared that the horse should go to his true owner. Aram asked when would they have to return the horse, to which Morad said in 6 months. He threw the bird into the air. It almost fell twice but flew at last. For the next 2 weeks, they both would take the horse and the horse out of the barn and ride it. But every morning the horse would throw Aram and ran away whenever he tried to hide it. He still hoped he would learn to ride it the way his cousin did. Once the way to the deserted vineyard to hide the horse again, they met John Bryo, who was on his way to town. Morad insisted on talking to him as he had a way with farmers. And moving to the next paragraph, it says that Morad wished him good morning and Bryo saw the horse carefully. Bryo wished them back and asked the name of the horse. Morad said, "My heart," in Armenian language. Brian complimented that it was a lovely name for a lovely horse. He saw that it was his horse that was stolen weeks ago. He asked if he could look into his mouth. After looking from tooth to tooth, he said that it was his horse. He further said that his family is all for honesty, but the horse looks just like the one he lost. a man who is suspicious would easily believe his eyes and not his heart. He wished them and went away. Murad wished him back. Next morning, what happened? They took the horse back to John Brier's vineyard and put it in his barn. The dogs followed them around without making any sound. Murad replied that they would not bark at them since he had a way with the dogs. Murad put his arms around the horse, then pressed his nose into the horse's nose. He patted him and then they went away. The same afternoon, John came to Aram's house in his sarai and showed his mother his horse that returned. He said that he did not know what to think as the horse is much stronger now with a better temper, and he thanked God. Uncle Khosrow who was in the parlor again shouted, irritated, "Quiet, man, quiet. Your horse has been ridden. Pay no attention to it." So this was the story given in your lesson. I have explained you the paragraph wise, which is given in your textbook. So let's do the recap of this summary again, which is given in your this lesson.